I'm assuming that from your previous classes you're familiar with using a TI-83 or 84 graphing calculator. However, there's a couple of things that we just want to briefly review, specifically how to do some basic graphing operations with a calculator. It's pretty straightforward, but there are a few kind of catches that can make it complicated, problems that I've seen students run into in the past. So what we want to do in this case is take a look at solving a few examples of questions where we're given some function and we want to match that with its corresponding graph. So in this first example, we want to graph 9 over x. So to do that, we can go to the y equals screen and then enter our function, 9 divided by x, and then click the graph button to get to that graph window. Now, in this case, I can't see the graph at all. I have a coordinate axis here, but there's no graph drawn. The reason being is that my window settings are probably incorrect for this graph. So this is sort of the trick with graphing with a TI calculator. So in order to change the window settings, we want to click on the window button, take a look back at our graphs that were given. In this case, we can see that the domain for each graph, each picture, is from negative 14 to 14. So our x values are going from negative 14 to 14. So we can change our x min value and our x max value to match those. And instead of setting the y min and y max values, what we'll do then is select the zoom feature and scroll down that list until we find an option that says zoom fit. So option 0 on my calculator. So that zoom fit feature, what it does is basically automatically adjusts the y-axis based off the x values that we selected. So now we have a clearer picture of what that graph should look like, and we can match it up with the graph that we're given. Or look at the graphs that we're given to see which one is the best fit. In this case, I'm going to say it's option B that looks like our best choice. And that matches up. So we're going to take a look at just using that exact same feature, setting the window and then adjusting it, to look at a couple more graphs. So in this case, we've got a slightly more complicated function, 100 divided by 1 plus e to the negative t. And we're given a domain here from 0 to 7. So going back to that y equals screen, we can clear the function that we had. Typing in this expression, we'll type in that numerator. And then we'll divide by this entire expression in the denominator, 1 plus, using the second key, we can access that e to the x feature. So we'll get 1 plus e to the negative x, which serves the same purpose as a t here. We can close that off, but again, our window setting isn't going to match the window settings for those options we have to look at. So we'll go back to that zoom screen. Go down to that option 0 or the 10th option in the list. Select Zoom Fit. And actually, I'm going to go back. I skipped a step. I didn't change my values for X min and X max. So let's actually change that. So we need our X min to be 0, X max to be 7. We can go back to that zoom screen and we can either scroll down or, since it's option 0, if I hit a 0, it'll access that zoom fit feature for me. And now it'll give us that graph that we're looking for that'll match up with one of those options on the other screen. So in this case, it looks like what we're looking for is graph A. So we'll briefly look at one last example here. In this case, we're given a function, 0.4x squared minus x minus 7, and we want to select the graph that depicts that intersecting with a second function, g of x equals 3. So we'll clear that y equals screen and type in this new function that we're given, so 0.4x squared minus x minus 7. And what we want to do is construct a graph, excuse me, that shows the intersection of that function with the function g of x equals 3, or y equals 3. So we're also given a domain here. In this case, each graph is shown in a negative 10 to 10 viewing window. So if we go to that window screen, select xmin to be negative 10, xmax to be positive 10, and then select that zoom screen, and then press 0 for that zoom fit option. We'll again get a window that's going from negative 10 to positive 10 and graphing our two functions. So we've got that parabola that we were given, that quadratic function, and then just the straight line y equals 3, which we can match up with the corresponding graph, which looks like probably A in this case. And you would repeat that for B and C. So that's just a quick review of how to do some different graphing features with the TI-84 calculator. Again, that I've seen some people have some confusion with at the start of the semester. So that'll help with some later applications. There's definitely a lot more features of the TI-84. On the module 1.1 page in the course shell, I've got links to a calculator quick reference guide, a TI-83-84 graphing calculator tutorial. So if there's other features that you're not familiar with, you can certainly feel free to contact me or make use of those features just to brush up on some of the skills and some of the things that the calculator is going to be able to do for us.